In this video, we are traveling to Pamban Island, which is also known as Rameshwaram Island. So, welcome to iExplore, and before starting the video, let's start with a short recap. On our journey so far, we were at Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of India. And for going to Vivekananda Rock Memorial, you have to take ferry, which will charge you Rs. 50 per person. The rock is famous for Swami Vivekananda, who attended enlightenment on the rock. Just beside the rock memorial, you will see the Thiruvallavar statue along with the massive view of Triveni Sangam. One can experience the sunset and moonrise both at the same time if you are traveling to Kanyakumari. Next morning we woke up at 5 for the sunrise, and trust me, it was the best sunrise I have ever experienced in my life. It was a free day with no plans, so we decided to explore the near areas of Kanyakumari. Morning with the local idli sambar along with this kind of view is more mesmerizing. Beside the view tower there is a fish aquarium where you can visit and see many unique fishes. After that we explored the market areas, had our lunch and enjoyed the sunset, which was obviously the last sunset at Kanyakumari. We will cover the distance of Kanyakumari to Rameshwaram by train overnight. Rameshwaram, locally known as Pamban, is a small island situated at the southeastern part of Tamil Nadu. The island is famous across the globe for Lord Rama, and it is said that Ram Setu starts from Dhanushkoti, which is the most traveled tourist destination here. The Ram Setu is approximately 18,400 years old and is famous by the name of Adam's Bridge, which is 35 kilometers long, connecting Sri Lanka from India. Due to a cyclone in 1964 affecting the town Dhanushkoti, along with the Ram Setu, got submerged 10 meters under the water. After reaching Rameshwaram, we booked a cab from the railway station itself, which costed us around Rs. 1800 for the sightseeing of the island. And our first destination is Dhanushkoti. While going to Dhanushkoti, you will see Bay of Bengal on left hand side and Indian Ocean on the other side. If the Hindu mythology is correct, then we are at a place where once Lord Rama started building Ram Setu to Lanka. Have you seen the great Bay of Bengal so quiet? No, right? But at Dhanushkoti, waves are nearly minimal. After spending some time at Dhanushkoti, we moved forward to our next destination, where Vibhishan from Lanka came in search of Lord Rama and joined him to rescue Sita. It is said that after Ravana was killed, Vibhishan was made the king of Lanka at this place only. So our next stop is the house of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the greatest scientist and a legend. Just a few kilometers from Dr. Kalam's house, there is a Ram temple where you can still see some floating ruins.
नकली वाला है।
This is the Lakshman temple where Lord Lakshmana dipped into the pond to resolve his sins. Ramanatha Swami temple was the last place to visit, but cameras were not allowed inside the temple premises. So, if you are coming or traveling to Ramanatha Swami temple, come 2 hours prior because the temple is pretty big to walk through. Rameshwaram is connected by both railways and roadways, so you won't have any transportation problem over there. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, do comment down below and subscribe to our channel I Explore, where I explore to amaze you all.